What's up, this is Unrivaled Skyrim, and today I'll be providing commentary over another battle for the Gates of Avalon tournament. This was played between another AVA team and played between another Zeal team. On team AVA, we have TJFplox, he's playing as Pergamon. We have Kyuzo, who is playing as Tillis, and Gherkinhead, he is Pontus. On team Zeal, we got Barca playing as Carthage. Playing as Syracuse, we have Phillip the Fifth, and HYDRA is playing as Sparta. So let's go ahead and jump into this match. This is still round one, and just still being played on the Battle of Amnesia. Is played between the other AVA team and the RTK clan. Let's go ahead and slow it down just for a tad. TJFplox, he has, his infantry consists of Galatian swords, he's got two units of slingers, and his general is in a Pergamese noble cavalry. Gherkinhead, he has mercenary Celtic warriors. Let's see here, I think four or five. Yeah, it's four of those. And he has a unit of naked swords, and he's got two Pontic swordsmen, and he has a unit of side chariot hiding back in the forest over here. Back over on the right flank, we have Kaizu, he's commanding Tillis. His general is an Oathsworn. He's got three Celtic warriors, one raiding horseman, and two of these tribal warriors, which is a pretty cool unit. He's at my door. It's alright. On Team Zeal, we have a Sparta commanded by HYDRA. He's just commanding a whole bunch of Spartan hoplites, and his general is in. He was a Sparta unit. Syracuse is being played by Phillip the Fifth. He's got his lancers and mercenary companion cab, and I think he's got two units of Samnite warriors. And Barca, he's commanding Carthage. He's got a unit of African war elephants, and his general has got Libyan Peltis, and I think he's got four late Libyan hoplites, or five of those, I don't know. But let's go ahead and put it to normal speed. Both armies are, looks like they're going to meet in the center, but it looks like Team AVA will have the height advantage. And it looks like Team AVA, they are flanking on both wings. They have a very spread out formation compared to Team Zeal, which is kind of compacted in the center over here. They're going to try to use these hoplites to really hold off the rush that AVA is going to present. But they are going to, Gherkinhead's going to charge forward with his infantry, but they're going to get charged by these mercenary companion cav, and they're just going to get pretty much destroyed from that charge. Now, Gherkinhead, he does have some infantry in reserve, so he's going to get a frenzy charge. His naked swordsman and his Pontic swordsman is going to counter charge his companion cav, but they're going to really leave without not too many casualties. But they did route two units, and it looks like another unit is routing as well, or at least it's wavering. And it looks like Philip the Fifth, he used rally, and let's see, I'm going to slow it down a little bit. So there is a mass infantry and cavalry fight on the right flank in the center. Barca, he's going to move up his late Libyan hoplites. He needs to get them in hoplite wall so they'll last longer. I think he's doing that right now. Yes, he does. And he's going to charge through his own men with his elephants, and he's going to try to take out all of these units over here. There's not really that many skirmishers to withhold all those elephants. But he's just buying time. TJFplox is buying Kyuzo time to flank on the left. Now, HYDRA, he does have these Spartan hoplites to intercept these units. He's going to do so with his Spartans. He should have had these Spartans more spread out. I mean, he has two of them really compacted together. They could have defended more ground. But it looks like Kyuzo is going to get a successful rear charge from the right on these late Libyan hoplites. These late Libyan hoplites are discharging their javelins on these this unit of Osworn. So that Osworn's going to take a lot of casualties over here on the right flank. Looks like there's a huge cavalry engagement. Let's go ahead and put it in normal speed and take a cinematic look into that. So, Phillip the Fifth, he brought some good cavalry, but they're very expensive, so he couldn't really bring anything else. I mean, he did bring two Samnite warriors, which I don't quite know where they're at right now. I think, one's over here. He's taking on this Pontic swordsman, but is getting shot from the rear from one of TJFplox's slingers. But looks like these companion cav going to get pretty much swamped by all this infantry, and this Hippias Lancer is going down. So I think that was where his general was at. Let's see here. Let's take a look on the center. Now, pretty much in the center, Barca, he's pretty much losing all of his Libyan hoplites. They were broken through by all the Tillis units, and now it's coming down to his pretty much all his Libyan peltes are trying to withhold all those tribal warriors. And these elephants, they did pretty much destroy all TJFplox's infantry, but they're starting to take a lot of damage, and they're amassing over 300 kills, but they're pretty much going to be done for pretty soon. They are still getting kills. Let's see, on the right flank, looks like this unit of side chariot has been activated, and it looks like TJFplox is going to try to flank around. Good idea. These Spartan hoplites, they were posted over here on the right flank to help defend the center, but the center has pretty much been lost because of the good use of teamwork by TJFplox and Kyuzo. They've successfully one person really held off the Carthaginian player while the other charged from the flank. That pretty much sealed the deal in the center. Now on the right flank, these Spartans are still holding off because they did have a favorable position and they are in spot hoplite wall, but they now. Now TJFplox is able to use his Pergamese Noble Cav, and they're going to get some deadly rear charges. Let's follow that unit around. And at the same time, Gherkinhead is going to try to use his side chariot to get some rear charges on the Heroes of Sparta unit. And there you just saw TJFplox charging that unit. So he's going to cycle charge, good thing, maximize the usefulness of his shock cavalry, very expensive shock cav too. See, they're gonna get good charges on these Spartans. There really wasn't that much Barca could have done in this situation. He had nothing to really protect himself. Team AVA used some good teamwork to hold up their opponents and just outflank them using teamwork. Over here, pretty much Spartans are done on this flank. Pretty much what's left is just these two Spartans over here. And see, these side chariots are not really getting very good charges. And I think Gherkinhead was a little upset with his chariots in this battle, that they weren't able to really amass that many kills. I mean, right here, they could have gotten some kills. I think they don't even get at least 40 kills, I think they get, but not much more than that. So it's pretty much battle's over with. Team AVA used some good teamwork to hold off their opponents and to outflank them. Zeal, they tried to protect their flanks with the Spartan hoplites, but it wasn't good enough. I think if they had more units, it would have helped them. But these Spartan hoplites, they're not too expensive, but they're expensive enough in these 3,000 denarii battle fun battles that they are that this tournament's having couldn't really afford that many units to protect their flanks, which I think could have helped them a lot. But yeah, very good game on both sides. I think if I were to pick the man of the match in this case, will even though Team AVA, they all did fairly well, especially Kyuzo and TJFplox. I'd say the man of the match in this case will be TJFplox. He did a good job. Not to say that Kyuzo and Gherkinhead didn't. I think he got the most kills. But Kyuzo did play a very good role of smashing Barca in the center, and he did a pretty good job of getting around Hydra's Spartans. But yeah, thanks for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, and like always, see you guys later. Peace.